To make a baby, there must be a rendezvous between a handsome, strong sperm and an egg princess. The magical union requires physical contact, so the princess must leave the sanctuary of the ovary and venture forth into the fallopian tube. If she's out and about, when the sperm gets there, he'll find her and make history. Some eggs run into some serious opposition. An unexpected bully blocks the exit door, thwarting the great escape. No escape, no tete-tete, no pitter-patter. The bully's name is testosterone. The reason this burly hunk is hanging out in the ovary, which by definition is girly land, is because enzymes within the ovary have become supercharged by the excess insulin. A tit-for-tat scenario. Who can help? Join us for this episode of Better Body Chemistry TV to learn who can help the princess make the great escape. Better Body Chemistry TV is brought to you by Dr. Sandy, a scientist turned gremlin buster, helping you battle sugar gremlins and heifer lumps and other health horribles through better body chemistry. Remember, small things can make a big difference to your health. Now, insulin comes out to play when there's food around. Researchers from Tel Aviv University wondered if by altering when food was around, they could help these trapped princesses escape the tyranny of their androgen oppressor and thus facilitate desired unions. The researchers enlisted the help of 60 skinny women, all with a PCOS diagnosis, and put them on a special diet for 12 weeks. Now, this wasn't a diet that restricted calories. They were allowed to consume up to 1,800 calories per day and could eat what they liked. The diet part of the program came in terms of when all the calories were consumed. Half the ladies ate a big breakfast with a smallish lunch and a teeny dinner. The other half of the ladies ate a teeny breakfast, a smallish lunch, and ended the day with a big dinner. Now, the ladies loading up early in the day, the breakfast club, were able to ditch the testosterone bully. Free testosterone levels were down by 50%. And with the bully out of the picture, a lot more princesses managed to fly the coop. Ovulation rates increased significantly, leading to a lot more historical moments in the tubes. It seems eating a big breakfast is an easy fix for PCOS. I know, eating a big breakfast might seem a little daunting, but it can be worked into your schedule. A few issues may need to be addressed. The first, and by far the hardest, will be persuading your jet-setting stomach that it needs to live in the same time zone as the rest of you. If you force the issue for a couple of days, your stomach and its hormones will adjust. You will be able to stomach food before noon. The second problem, time. You'll need to get up early enough to do breakfast. Don't leave it up to chance. Decide what you are going to do for breakfast before you hit the sack. And hit the sack earlier The third problem, you don't like eggs. Breakfast doesn't mean eggs. It could be anything. The key is to include protein in your meal. Still feeling overwhelmed? Remember the why. If you help your egg princess break free, you increase the odds that you add a princess or a prince to your family, if this is your goal. If not, it will help you feel like a princess. Unfortunately, the presence of a testosterone bully can undermine your health by causing you to put on weight, giving you spots, thinning your hair, upsetting your menstrual cycles. And long term, it puts you at risk of heart disease and diabetes. If you're insulin resistant, then you need to learn how to deploy the candy floss system. You can find out more at www.sugargremlin.com. When you're there, enroll in our free e-course and check out our free video series that explain just how sugar gremlins get up to mischief. Looking for more ways to create better body chemistry to optimize your health? Visit www.betterbodychemistry.com. for tips and strategies to help you create better body chemistry. The advice is simple to follow and based on real science, not hype. Got friends and family that are battling with PCOS? Spread the word by sharing this video and subscribe to our channel so you can discover the small things that make a big difference to your health. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.